Good morning. Good morning, brothers and sisters. This is CmdrAleon. Yes, we were on last night. Last night's show is on my YouTube channel, Astro Command Spaceship News. I got a little bit of enigma going on the app here this morning. It's an overcast, rainy day. A little bit rainy, not on and off. We're in beautiful southern New England in Connecticut here on the planet Earth. Hey, alien doll, good to see you. Manessa, Mike G, everybody coming in around the planet Earth. ABS, AM, SMAR, Mike G, let's see who else we got. Mary, Old Soul, Alien Doll, good to see you, please, and thank you. That's good. Mike G, thank you for the likes. This is the number one spiritual UFO talk show, normally on at nighttime. Scott Hammond, good to see you. We're trying to do some morning shows. I have my day off, so I'm just kind of enjoying the morning here, doing some Earth-based things here as well, and good to have you all here. Nana, Nocturial, I think it is, Nocturnal. Good to see everybody coming in here. You're watching the number one spiritual UFO talk show. If you're not watching this show and you're on some other TikTok watching balloons going up in the air, then you're watching the wrong thing. So come on in here and join us. If you're passing by, say, oh, this is this guy's on here talking about spaceships and ETs and star people and contact. This is where it's happening, folks. Right on Encounters. This is the number one spiritual UFO talk show on social media. I'm also, I can tell you if you're new, I'm on radio for 21 years on NPR Pacifica Radio. And we've been on there doing a show called The Cosmic Eye for 21 years, going on 21 years in 2024. Jackie F., good to see you. So I've interviewed all kinds of people on radio for 21 years. I'm a contactee. So the thing I get over a lot of people, if you're not a contactee, is that I've actually had physical contact when I was a kid with space people that look like us. They're not monsters. They're not like the War of the Worlds where they look really weird and everything. I actually had contact with space people, men, women, and children, on a spaceship and a flying saucer in the 60s or before my teenage years. And so I'm a contactee. I've had numerous sightings of spaceships. I don't even call them UFOs. I identify them as non-terrestrial spaceships in my experiences. I've had a sighting of a ship, if you're new to the show, back in the 80s. The ship was about 2 foot fields in length, and it was hovering over a hill above condo complex in a place called the Nutcracker Valley in Connecticut. I watched it for 35 minutes after I came out of the club setting up. I used to do reggae concerts, with music. Play music like vinyl, like Bob Marley and all that. And we do these reggae dance parties. And as I was going out, I heard a voice say, look up. And I'm in this sparsely lit parking lot, and there was a Stop and Shop supermarket on the other end, but there was not a lot of cars, and a McDonald's across the way on this road going out of the shopping center. And above the condo complex, I'm watching a spaceship for 35 minutes. And then it shoots out two beams of light, one kind of orange, one yellow, and they're doing all kinds of geometry. And then I call up the local ABC affiliate, and they're telling me it's a bunch of air pilots doing formation. I said, tear up your paper. This is before there were cell phones, before there was like internet and all this stuff. I said, tear up your paper, because I'm standing here in the parking lot on my phone talking to this lady, and I'm telling her I'm looking at a spaceship over 2 football fields in length, hovering and spinning around slowly over a condo complex, and all kinds of lights or multicolored lights are going on. And, this is a true story. This happened in my life. And, you'll never see the picture because I was taken off guard. I went out, before I went out of the club, it was a blues club. It was, there was nothing going on. It was just setting up for the weekend. I go out and I hear a voice say, as I go out, look up, in plain English saying, look up. I look up and the spaceship is right there. I felt like I was just being telepathically communicated with the whole word look up in plain English in my consciousness. I looked up, the ship was right there. I couldn't, what am I going to do? So I'm in my little Ford car. I'm sitting in the car watching this thing for 35 minutes. But I had no way of documenting it because it just happened, It was one of those things that happened. So I looked up and it was right there. So now I'm a contactee. I have a real strong background in the subject. For those that don't, this is a good place to learn, but I have a lot of experience, a lot of things going on with this whole subject in a positive way. And that's why I do what I do on radio and what I do here is a show called Encounters, the number one spiritual UFO talk show. So when in the 70s, when I was with my mother and aunt, Mary Roland. So we also do on here, we like to do interviews. So we have a protocol for interviews, and we're going to do some of that this morning. If you want to be on the show as a guest, you want to share your visitations by space people, if you had popsicle things happening in England or whatever, if you have mer people that you've actually experienced, or fairies, or Bigfoot sightings, or Sasquatch related stuff, this show is really focused on that area. We don't get into the paranormal, so there's tons of other people on social media doing paranormal stuff. We're strictly involved in this subject area, galactic, cosmic, contact, all the whole bit. So welcome to the show, everybody, coming in here. If you're new to the show, we're usually, like I said, we're on at 11 o'clock at night, mostly. And we have a big audience at night in the evenings. And as you get to know my show here, you're going to be addicted to it. Mary Roland, thank you for the lightning bolts. We appreciate that so much. My Venmo account is in my profile. If you wish to do a Cash App Venmo and you like what we're doing, that's a direct way to help support my mission work here with the show here on TikTok. And we appreciate everybody coming in here. I do acknowledge all of you. I see people coming in here. So if I don't say your name, you know, I know you're here. So welcome to the show. Jackie F., thank you. Jackie, always good. Thank you for the hat. We appreciate that very much. So this is why I love to do interviews. I just posted last night's show on my Ashtar Command Spaceship News channel on YouTube. So my YouTube channel is Ashtar Command Spaceship News. You can watch all the previous shows on there. My radio shows, my encounter shows are all on Ashtar Command Spaceship News. So check that out when you have time. We'd love to have you get to watch some of those shows that you missed. Matter of fact, so to be on the show, number one, you have to be over 18, no kids on camera. Number two, no foul language of any sort on the show. Number three, no drugs. That means no drugs whatsoever in general. Number three, no drinking. No any drunken people on here. We won't put you on here. You'll be, sent out into the universe pretty quick. Number five, again, no. Number four, no paranormal discussion. There's tons of other places for that kind of dialogue. And let's see, what else is there? That's pretty much it. Those are really the main rules of the show, and we're glad to have everybody here. And I know many of you are finding us this morning for the first time. Some of you already have been with us since last year when we got on TikTok. But if you're new here, you're going to be having a great time on the show. And we'd like to hear your story. So the way it works is you need to have, by TikTok's rules, over 200 people. Hi, Commander, Sunday show is missing on YouTube. Are you going to post it? I had a glitch in the system trying to post it. I think I might have lost the show, but I'm not sure. I'll have to take a look. Lexicon, thank you. I had two or three shows through the last few months that I had problems loading up or something. But, you know, that happens technically, but I'm trying to get all my shows on there. And most of them, if I can get them on there, I will. I got too much memory that I used, and I ended up losing some things. But, other than that, so like I said, you have to have 200 plus people to get on audio on TikTok. If you have over 800 people, evidently, they changed it. It used to be 1,000. If you have over 800 followers, you could come on audio and video, like one of my guests last night did. She had over 800 followers, and she's able to come on live now people are able to come on live on audio and video. When you come on here, if you have the ability to use the camera and you are not indisposed, we'd like to have you on camera with a real face, not just a picture. So make sure you're ready to come on camera. Get yourself ready. Take the time to prepare to go on live with us, and we'll have you on camera. I want to bring more of that energy. If you have only 200 followers, I can't do that anyway. But if over 800 plus, get your camera ready. If you say you want to talk about your sighting or your visitation, if you have to comb your hair or get, whatever, make sure you do that first. So we're going to have a good show today. Like I said, there's a lot going on. We're in a great time of a lot of things going on. We have our Ashtar Command C5 contact gathering happening on May 25th, and that's going to be at a apple orchard here in the United States in Connecticut. And we've been using that apple orchard for over 11 plus years. And we're going to be doing, if you're not familiar with C5, it's where we attempt to make visual contact with our star family. And visual contact means them showing their spaceships to us, and we're able to document and record whatever we see. So that's going to be happening coming up tomorrow night. I'll be making the video after the show. We're doing our Friday night a thing that we do that you're not aware of or you don't know about. We do a thing called Ashtar Command Q&A. So on Friday nights, we'll have April on from Vermont. She's been with the Ashtar Command ships for over 12 times. She's documented every photo on her security cameras, and you'll be able to ask questions about these things. So everything I talk to you about here is based on my experiences, my years of experience with the subject that some of you don't have. You can certainly ask questions and open your consciousness up to the subject. If you're not, you know, let's just put it this way. Most human beings on this planet have been bogged down by lies on social media, on TV media, cable TV, regular TV, you name it. It's all out there. You know, so for 70 years and also 70 years of world governments basically covering up the fact that we are visited by people from other planets, totally been done for about over 70 years in our current lifetime. And so we're here to bust the matrix, and that's what we do here. We bust people's belief systems. So if you believe everything you're told by the government, we're going to bust your matrix. We're gonna challenge you to think beyond the box. You know what I mean? That's what we do here. Hey, Real Talk Newscastle, good to see you. And, you know, it's just, hey, Luna, good to see you. Luna LaBella. LaBella, good to see you. Pookie Bear, thank you. Good to have you all with us. So once you watch this show a few times, you're going to see the commander operates a little bit differently as a talk show host, you know? And we kind of push people's buttons in a good way. Those that are kind of closed, we don't get many closed-minded people, but they are. I'm going to push those people who are thinking in the head. So I'm going to try to get you to go out of this into the heart center, which is more the spiritual part of who you are. So that's what we do here also on this show. All right, so welcome to the show. We got a little bit of enigma behind me here. And we're glad to have everybody here. If you do have a story to tell, if you've had any contacts, don't be afraid to share it on this show. If you've been having regular contacts with star people, light beings, what have you, we want to hear your story. If you've had sightings happening recently, wherever you are in the world, whether it be in Europe or the United States, South or Central America, and you're watching this show and you have over 200 followers or we're 800, come on the show. We're inviting you to come on here and share your story with us. We'd like to hear it this morning. And it's a beautiful, even though it's cloudy here, it really is a beautiful day. Good to have everybody with us. This is Encounters. Welcome. I'm Commander Aleon. If you're new coming in here, you know, you don't usually see me on in the mornings. You say, oh, there's a show called Encounters, and we do exist, you know. You know, believe it or not, we actually have a show here. So we're a talk show. We're not one of these. I see TikTokers where they're all yelling at each other. They want to have debates and all this stuff. We don't do that here. This is a national talk show. I come from my background in media. I've done TV in the Intergalactic TV Network years ago. I'm, like I said, on NPR radio for 21 years now, and I do my own thing, and they let me do it on NPR radio, one of the few stations on NPR's network where I can talk about the Ashtar Command and space people and all that stuff. So that's what this is. We'd love to hear from you. If you have a story to tell, let us know in comments what your experience is. Like one comment I have, seen UFOs last night, or I'm being visited by space people. All I need to know is specifically what that is. And if you have enough people following you, I can bring you on here this morning and we can have a great discussion regarding your experience. So I'm sure there are some people out there. You're probably thinking, should I do this or not do it? Just go for it. You know, we'll treat you with respect. This is not, you know, the chop and block show where we have people on and they talk about being visited and we say, oh, no, you didn't. You know, we definitely encourage people to come out of the closet, share their stories here. And I know, you know, but we're leaving an environment in the United States and probably worldwide where, you know, in the current history, I've not heard of the foundation, Luna. I'm not sure what that is. But we live in an environment where people have been, you know, years ago, people say, oh, I can't say anything because people think I'm this or that or whatever. 30 years later, let me say something. That most people around the world now are more open to the whole idea of people visiting our planet than they were 30 years ago. You might have one or two people in your neighborhood that say, oh, I know her or him, that I don't believe any of their things they're saying. But the general worldwide public, over 80% of the public believes that there's extraterrestrial intelligence beyond Earth. 80%. And that poll was done years ago, probably the last 10 years or whatever. So look at where we are now versus 3 years ago. That's why this kind of show is here, because people are ready for the truth. People want to know about these things. People want to share their experiences. They want to have a place where they can come. I've made this show a place where people can actually come here, get on the show, and share for the first time what they've been going through. That's what I do here. And I'm very committed to the mission of doing this. I want people to feel comfortable around the world when they find this show. And I want them to come out of the closet, share their experiences. No one's going to ridicule you. No one's going to put you down here. Not even me. I'm a contactee, you know. I've had my experiences, you know what I mean? You know, so I want you to think about it. And if you, hey, Chris, good to see you, brother. I want to see if you feel like you can share your story. Everyone learns from everybody's stories here. And for people that have no experiences, don't feel bad about it. Until, you know, that you have no experiences yet. You will eventually have experiences. Everybody will. The whole planet will. It's just a given at the time frame we're in right now. We're getting into a mode where you want to know why there's so many spaceship sightings. I don't even call them UFOs. You know, we have the reverse engineered spaceships that our governments are using that can confuse people. But the real spaceships, the ones that are coming from our inner Earth, coming from our oceans, the ones coming from outer space, those are our star family. Those are our space people. Those are people that are coming here now because it's time for them to come here. It's time for people to get ready for something beautiful, something that's going to transform our planet. Now, you look at the planet, if you watch the regular news, it's the same news cycle every day on the international news. Same cycle, wars, people dying, you know, whatever. It's always the same cycle. They never talk about this. They'll never talk about this on ABC or BBC or CBC or China News or Russian TV or whatever. They won't talk about it. Why? Because this is what's really happening. The fact is, brothers and sisters, we're getting ready for some major contact in the next year and a half or two. And they won't talk about it. They won't talk about it on Good Morning America or good, you know, or whatever. Oh, that's funny. Alexa stopped playing some music there. But they'll never talk about this, right? But we will. We're talking about it here. We're here to bust everyone's matrix. Toolman, yes, we are from Mars. So that's the other thing. And I came out of the closet years ago when I was a kid, and my friends in my neighborhood were playing stickball, and they got really angry when I said I came from Mars, you know? That, and then I went underground. I didn't say anything more until I got old enough to understand what that was. And when I became an adult and opened my consciousness back up, I was able to come out of the closet on my radio show and say, I'm from Mars. Yes, I am. So when I say I'm from Mars, Mars is a planet of 10 to 15 million inhabitants of spiritual human beings that live on Mars. Contrary to anything anybody creates on the internet, on social media about Mars, being from Mars, I can tell you what the planet is like if you're interested. It's a planet of great beauty versus what you're being shown. Mars has an atmosphere similar to Earth. It has a blue sky, a light blue sky. It has oxygen on the planet. Mars had problems millions upon millions of years ago when they were trying to develop some other technologies. It backfired, but they have not, you know, they've learned from that experience. And the Martian population, some of it lives above the surface. And a lot of it lives below the surface. There's waterways below the surface. There's a polar cap on Mars. Sometimes you'll see it with astronomers' telescopes. There is a polar cap like there would be a polar cap on Earth. So Mars is right currently about 10 to 15 million people, to answer your question, that live there. They live in a Christ consciousness. They are spiritual beings of light. Unlike Earth, the vibration on Earth is getting way better. But it's not the same vibration as Mars. Mars operates in a completely different vibration, even though it's in the same solar system, in the same galaxy, and so forth. Denise says, I'm a Palladian. Hey, glad to meet you, Denise. This is what I mean. When someone can come out of the closet in comments and say, I am a Palladian. That's excellent. That's exactly what we want to see. We want to see people not be afraid to be who they are. You know how all these movements in the 60s that were same-sex, those same-sex liberation movements, now you're going to see those that are starseed coming out of the closet, and people are going to have to deal with it in our general society. There are people that are not going to contain themselves anymore saying, I'm just a human being. They're going to say, I am a Palladian. I came from Andromeda star system. I came from this star system. I remember. So it's time for people to remember, because that's the time we're living in. So it's going to, you know, a lot of people, your neighbors might say, you're a Palladian? How's that possible? It's time for those that came from other planets to come out of the closet, to be who they are. And I'm a proponent of that liberation of consciousness, that people do not have to be afraid to be who they are. It's time for people to stand up and say that I am a starseed. I remember my star family. I remember coming here. You have nothing to be ashamed of here on the show if you say that. I will support you as host of the show 1,000%. And those that might poo-poo it, you won't be here too long. You know, so I use my power in a very appropriate way in terms of what I do here. Like I said, I've been doing this for a lot of years. Metaphysician says, you see, well, she wouldn't be gray. She would be, I'm not sure how you would figure that out. I'm not sure gray. She might be, there's no such thing as a gray anyway. It's just an Earth-based term. If you're saying she's a Zeta, you might want to look deeper into that. She probably isn't. She's probably something else. But again, we'd have to examine that there, metaphysician. And I, good to see you, brother. Let's see here. James Henry, welcome. Lynn, everyone coming into the show. So, Davina, thank you for the roses. We appreciate that. I got to set my goals up here. For this morning, I'm pinning my goals with a hat and mustache. We usually like to do that. We have my Cash App is on Venmo on my profile page. So please Venmo whatever you wish during the show or after the show or during the show, actually. You should do that. So good to have you with us. I just put my my thing up here for 8 total hats, brown hats with a mustache. That helps support the work I do. Does UFO contact you in the brain? Joe, I think it's Josh B420. So it's UFOs don't do anything. UFOs are just a transportational vehicle. What's in the UFO or the spaceship, Josh, I think what you're talking about are the space people. So the UFOs don't do the contact. They're just a physical transport vehicle to get from one place to the other. The space people will telepathically contact you if you're connected with them. Yes, they can contact you. The people that are on the spaceship can definitely do contact through telepathic communications. So I understood the question. So just let people know, UFOs do not communicate with people. They're just spaceships. They're just vehicles. The beings inside the specific vehicle, man or woman or whatever, can telepathically reach you through conscious communications with your brain. Absolutely. Great question. I've always had super abilities with technology since I was a child. Cat life. Interesting. You know, so there's, you know, these questions are great. If you have questions, I can answer anything cosmically, galactically related to this. I pretty much can answer it. If I don't have the answers to a specific question, I will certainly tell you that, and I'll be transparent about it. And you're watching Encounters, so welcome to the show. This is the number one spiritual nighttime UFO talk show. We're doing some morning shows here, and we're trying to get people used to the fact that we are here. We've been here for like over a year. But mostly at nighttime, we have a big audience at night. Please tap. We're going to go for 100,000 likes this morning. And that means everybody, I always like to integrate and get everybody watching the show involved in some way. So even if you don't come on the show and want to speak, you can tap your button. You can tap the screen and help us get up to 100,000 likes. You can do that as, you know, participants in that way, in a very subtle way. You can help, do that. So we appreciate it. Please follow us. If you're not following us, follow each other. By following us, we want to get by summer 100,000 followers to reach more people throughout the world in terms of the whole show and the whole messaging of the show. Angelica, good to see you. Yes, definitely hold space. I've always felt a connection to the Palladians. That's probably because you are connected to Palladians. I can't believe I didn't get my apple cider here. If I do step away from here for a minute, I forgot to get my apple cider. Hey, Johnny, good to see you. Everybody coming in here. I'll probably have to get some apple cider because I drink apple cider on my show. It's the prescribed drink of the commander. It's apple cider. Now, Robert, welcome. Everybody coming in here. So you'll find we're a bit different than every other YouTube or whatever on here is happening. Because of what we do, I think you're going to love the show. You're going to be addicted to the show. When you become addicted to encounters, you don't have to go to a non-addiction or anonymous program because you don't need it. When you're on this show and you get addicted to encounters, you're going to be here for the rest of your life until we go off planet. I guarantee it. And I have Enigma in the background. I love Enigma. I mean, Enigma is one of my favorite groups. Do star people contact us through dreams? Yes. Yes, absolutely. HD Crossbow and Z, your question is excellent. Many of the contactees, many people have contacts on dreams. I call that a cosmic dream reality, HD. So in your dreams, space people will meet you through the dream, what you call a dream, and they actually do have physical contact. So when you go to sleep and you have what we call a cosmic dream, if you have one, where you're meeting beautiful people and you're on a ship, you're most likely in your what you call a dream, you're being taken out of body through your spiritual body on the ship, which is one way that happens. And or what you think is a dream, they're taking you on the ship with your physical body and you're not in your bed anymore. So they make it sound like it's a dream and you're meeting them, but you're actually out of your body. You're not in your bed. You're probably not even in your room, your apartment, your house. You're probably on the ship. But they have ways of doing it gently so you'll think you're dreaming it when you're not dreaming it at all. Right? Good question. Doug says he wants a med bed. Well, let's talk about the med beds. For people that don't know what the med beds are, our space brothers and sisters have a thing called med beds. The med beds will be able to heal people of all their ailments, whether it's cancer, whether it's whatever it is. Once the med beds are now part of the transformational environment of our planet, once we ascend to that level, the med beds will be here to help people that have had all kinds of problems. So the med beds do exist. Matter of fact, our Ashtar Command ships have med beds on them. Because I work with the Ashtar Galactic Command, or Ashtar Command. I've been, like I said, I came from off-planet. I was an intergalactic communicator on the ship, using crystallized structures to communicate, unlike on Earth. So I'm fully conscious. I'm like an open cosmic book. I don't have to go to websites for people's information, or the commander, did you read this person's information? I am solely connected in space and time, beyond space and time. So all my information comes direct. So all my answers come within me. I don't need to go anywhere for information. Dad Jay, good to see you. But I appreciate your question, HD. Denise says, I had one. It was the feeling of love, unconditional love. I didn't want to leave. So just to talk about the med beds. So that's what the med beds do. They're essentially there. They will be available at some point to help people. And like I said, it'll be a great, beautiful experience once we have that capability of the med beds. Hey, Midnight, welcome to the show. Diorio, welcome to our show, Encounters. Welcome, everybody, to Encounters, the morning edition. Aisha, good to see you. Welcome. And Trenton, welcome to our show. So if you, hey, Peace, good to see you. Welcome to the show. If you have had any experiences, like if you've had encounters, if you've had visitations half of your life with space people, light beings, whatever, we want to hear your story. If you're having sightings right now, I know a lot of sightings are going on all over the world. People are videotaping stuff and documenting it. If you've had any sightings, we want to know about that. You can come on the show and share your story about your sightings. So put this, if you give me a sentence in the comment section here on Encounters, tell me why you want to come on the show. If you have over 200 followers, we can bring you on. If you have over 800, you can come on live. make sure you're just, you know, dressed and everything and ready to go on camera, and we'll bring you on live. So, Bill, I have a long story about the Palladian mate. It's so beautiful and very unconditional love. Stella Bella, we're going to bring you on. Why can't I bring you on? Oh, that's really weird. Stella Bella, press the request button because it says that I can't bring you on as a guest. That's kind of weird. On the bottom, there's a guest icon. See if you can press that, and we'll bring you on, Stella Bella. It might be your setting. I don't know. But you should have a ability to join us here. I'd love to hear your story. Let's see. I can't, Commander. I'm at, oh, you're at work. All right. Well, we'll have to get you when you're not at work. It sounds like you have a beautiful story to share. When you're not at work, maybe on our nighttime show, we'll have you on. But I'm very interested in that. Zero Lee, welcome to the show. Rachel, welcome to our show. Angela Hoots Gardner, Black Glide, welcome to our show. Brenda Ewig, Trav Russell, welcome to our show. This is Encounters, the morning edition. I know there's a lot of new people finding this show here. You're saying, what is this? This is Encounters. We are on usually at night. We have a really big show in the evening, and we're trying to do some morning shows here. And if you don't know much about me, if you're new here, I'm a contactee since the 60s with positive ET contact or star people contact. I've documented a lot of sightings over the years since since I was a kid. So I'm also with the Ashtar Galactic Command, so I work with the positive space people. I've worked with them for a good portion of my life. And we're just grooving with stuff here from Enigma. Enigma is very transformational. I loved Enigma when they first came out. Their music really moves the soul. Commander, I thought April already told you about my story. She did, but maybe other people have not heard about it. You know, a lot of new people here. So when you're able to come on, you'll be able to tell it to people that might not have heard about it. I love them going across my sky. Robinson 24. It sounds like you've been having sightings. Let's see. Robinson 24. Have you had sightings? It looks like you have, just by that one comment. Can I bring you on, Robinson 24? Would you like to be a guest on the show this morning? We're going to see if we can bring Robinson 24 as our first guest for this morning's Encounter Show. Chris, so you live in New York City, don't see a thing. New York City, that area, has had sightings over the years, a lot of UFO sightings. You just have to be aware, go to like the dock areas, go out where the Hudson River is, and just spend 2 hours looking at the sky. We're going to bring Robinson 24 on. If you can bring your camera on when you come on, that'd be great. I'm going to bring Alexa, turn on. Alexa, stop. Okay. So we're going to have Robinson on in a minute. Our first guest on Encounters. They can bring the camera on here.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, good morning. So how should I call you? Robinson?
You can just call me Robinson. Yeah, that works.
Oh, great. And whereabouts on the planet are you?
I'm near Missouri. I'm in Missouri.
In Missouri. Okay, great. Can you give us some background? I always love this. Can you tell us when things started happening for you in terms of the sightings?
I mean, I think they've been with me my whole life, but I was so indoctrinated and I was just under a shield. My eyes were like blocked until my spiritual awakening started around 2022.
Okay, great. And, you know, and that's natural. You know, we live in an earth human form, right? We have a human mind and saying, wait a minute, this can't be happening. You know, I always love how the mind tries, even with me, says, oh, Commander, you can't do this. I say, mind, shut up. So right. Tell us, in 2022, when things started happening, what was the first thing that happened in your experience?
So the first ship that I've probably seen was the ones that are round and they go rainbow color on you and they go spinning. I saw that one. And then I saw my other next one was a cylinder. It was blue. And that one was like right over my deck.
Really? And how low was the blue? How low was the blue one? How big was it?
I actually got a picture.
You do? Can you show the picture? We'd love to see the picture. Oh, this is going to be good. We're going to see a blue cylinder spaceship. And she's got a picture. This is going to be good. I can't wait to see this. Can you not wait to see this? I can't. I love when people can show pictures or video.
Okay, hold on. Let me try to find it.
No problem. Take your time. You're watching Encounters, by the way. Please, everybody, tap. We want to get to 100,000 likes. We have Robinson back on. She's going to show us the picture of the ship. A blue cylinder craft. No, no problem. Lisa, thank you for the roses. I appreciate that so much, Lisa. Oh, there it is. I guess I can put you on the big screen. Let me put you on the big screen here. Hold on a minute. It doesn't make much of a difference if I have you on the big screen or not. Well, let's look at that. Can you describe when that was, what year it was, what time it was, when that happened?
That was near the beginning of me seeing them. And what happened is I felt the urge to come outside.
You did?
Yeah, I did. I telepathically can get thoughts.
Can you move your head just away from the picture for a minute? Yeah. There you go. Everyone take a look at the picture.
Yeah. Go ahead. And so basically I felt like I should go outside. And then I was they were really close and I got really kind of, you know how, I mean, it's the beginning and I was like not really believing it.
Right. You couldn't believe what was happening, right? Yeah.
Exactly. And then I went back inside and then I came back out because they were like, you could come and like, we'll take it slow. We'll take the meeting slow. Yeah.
Wow. That's amazing. And that was your first experience when the veil, as someone said, second. So the veil was lifted from you in your consciousness to be open to this now. It was time for you to, you know, we all have our time when we wake up and it was your time, right? So when you were seeing that, I'm going to bring my camera back to its normal state. Let's see here. You know, when you, I'm going to do this here. Let's see here. So bring it back. Here we go. So when you had that experience, obviously that transformed your life. So they were telepathically it sounds like they were telepathically communicating with you, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, let's take a look at this. I'm going to bring this up. What's this picture?
It was a shape in the clouds like that, but yeah. I believe that some of them were cloaked into these. If you zoom in,
I'm gonna bring it up.
I can't zoom in on here, but
I can do it. Okay, so I'm gonna let everybody see it. Let you narrate without your head in the picture, and let tell people what we're looking at. Okay. Robinson's gonna tell us about this.
I don't know. So what happens is I feel the urge that I'm supposed to like videotape or take pictures.
Mm-hmm.
And then I do. And I take pictures for them.
Wow.
And I video them. Then yesterday I got like, so I can't show videos on here. But I kept getting them coming over my house. And like I've got two in a line going across my sky. I'm like, hell yeah, so cool.
So you actually should be able to show video. We had someone last night, they were showing video. Yeah, you can show video.
Oh, hold on, let me look.
If you have video of them, I think people would like to see that.
Well, let's look. Here I do.
Yeah. We're going to hopefully, you can do video, yeah.
Okay, let's see.
Yeah, she is, Johnny. She is connected to them. Yeah. And we have Robinson in Missouri, and she's showing us documented things since 2022. She is evidently very connected to the space people, and we're going to get into that a little bit, what I'm reading here.
Weird, it's not letting me pull up any videos.
Okay. That's kind of weird. Usually, you should be able to. Let me go back to this thing. I'm going back. I'm gonna do this here again. And let's see.
I can try again. I don't know.
Yeah, try again. If you can get the video going, we're gonna try to have her show some videos of the spaceships going over her house, which will be phenomenal if we can do that. Oh yeah.
If I
So
get the
yeah, that's
videos to play, if I get the
yeah,
videos to
Callie.
play.
Right. Now, Callie, you're right. If you have a separate phone, they were showing it from a separate phone. The person on last night, they used a separate phone to show the videos.
Yeah,
Do you have, is your video saved to like a camera or something, or to like we have an application where you have your video saved?
Do you have Facebook at all? I can message you
Yeah.
it.
Yeah, if you message me in on Facebook, I could or just message me here with the
I'll
video on
message
here,
you
TikTok.
here.
Message me here. And what I can do is, or send it to me on email, and I'll use my bigger tablet one morning or whatever. If I have the video, if you have a tablet, if you have your own email on a bigger tablet versus your cell phone, you send the video to your tablet and you can show it from your other tablet or whatever you have, like one of those little tablets. That's a way of being
Yeah.
able to do it. Yeah, you can't send, you're right, Avery. You can't send video to, but you can message me the video, and I can see it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my word. There you go. I don't know. That or I can figure out if I have.
Yeah.
Okay,
It'll
so
take
sometimes
time.
I can't really send videos on TikTok either. It's
Yeah,
weird.
it's a weird thing. So when these ships went over your location, look at, there's so many things, I have so many questions for you. When they went over, how big were these craft, and what did they look like? Can you explain?
I get the little ones, then they just go across my sky. And then sometimes, though, I'll get like where they're like, you could swear they're stars at first, but then they start like shimmering, blinking.
Yeah.
I'll zoom in on them and I'll get really good pictures of them. And then I see that they're not just stars and stuff.
Right. And you have an energy about you, because if you're new to my show, I read people's energy, because I don't come from this planet. I come from where I come from with the Ashtar command levels. I'm fully conscious of a lot of things. So I'll read energies, not because I'm trying to read energies. It's because when you tell a story, I understand many, thank you, Jackie. I read more things into it. So from what I saw in the first picture of the blue spaceship at night in your awakening state, where the veil was lifted, and they're telling you, they're talking to you telepathically, right? So they're communicating with you. Do you communicate with them, mind-to-mind communications? Have you done that?
Yes. I
Have
mean,
they?
I'm still not perfect at it, but yeah, I do.
Yeah, no, I know you do. I'm absolutely certain you do. Your energy is such at a level of you're not the same person you were before 2022, now or in 2024. So do you feel that you actually have transformed from the old you to a new you? Do you feel a difference?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not as close-minded as.
Yeah. Well, how could you be? I mean, look, they're right in front of you. What are you gonna, your mind's gonna tell you,
Exactly.
you can't look at this, Jack. You can't look at this, Miss Robinson. You can't look at it, and yet it's right there. So you have to tell your mind, be quiet, mind. This is a reality. It's happening, right?
Yeah, and like I had another video of my inside room where I am right now, and I
Yeah.
have a night camera, and I caught videos of like so many orbs going through my house.
Right.
Like,
I would say those orbs are actually galactic orbs versus orbs of people that have passed. There's a difference between paranormal orbs, which are not getting into paranormal, but what you're talking about is galactic orbs that are not of this planet, that are orbs that are,
videos. So do you have Messenger? Because I cannot send you on TikTok.
I have Messenger. Yeah, if you have Facebook Messenger, send it to me there, and I'll be able to do something.
Okay, what is your Facebook?
Commander Aleon, CmdrAleon, is my Facebook.
Hold on. Let me see.
If you see a CmdrAleon, you can also, and also you can email me. Why don't you just email me? Email me at CmdrAleon@AOL.com for the show. That's my show email. So CmdrAleon@AOL.com is my show email. Her encounters, just send it via email. I'll download it through email. That's really the easiest way to do it. Just email the videos or the pictures. Hey, Chrissy, good to see you. Everyone coming in here. Just directly email me. Email is the best way to do it.
Okay, Sorry.
Yeah, email me at CmdrAleon@AOL.com when you have a chance. And I'll get your footage. Give me a little story behind each one.
CmdrAleon.
And
CmdrAleon. Okay.
EON@AOL.com. That's my email address. That's really the most direct way to do it. That's better than anything else because my email is when people send me
videos. CmdrAleon.
@AOL.com. She's typing, I think. And everybody, welcome to the show. You're watching the morning edition of Encounters, the number one spiritual UFO talk show on social media. And I'm your host, Commander Aleon. I'm glad to have you all with us, brothers and sisters, wherever you are around the world, wherever country you're in. Welcome to the show. If you're in Russia, whether you're in Europe, whether you're in Scandinavia, we're glad to have everybody with us here this morning. And we have overcast skies in this part of the planet, but that doesn't stop us from having a beautiful day. And we're going to have a great day today, you know? We already are. You know, good morning, Willie. Good to see you. Ah, thank you, Chrissy. I'm glad you found us through Young Skywalker is phenomenal. So thanks for being here, Chrissy. Kay Smith, thank you for that. I appreciate that. Poe Girl, welcome to the show. Mercury Man in Vermont. Good to see you, brother. Sally, welcome to the show. We're actually going to ask some more questions as soon as she comes in. I think she's trying to send us stuff.
No, it exceeded the file size, so I have to message you.
Okay.
Then just
message me, that's fine.
Okay.
So I want to ask you about in Arkansas, you're seeing the orbs, but I have the feeling that you're also having, they want to directly physically contact you, not just the galactic orbs. The people on the ship, I'm going to tell you a little bit about them. Whenever I get this information, I just have to go with it. So you're having contact. The people on the ship, they are actually people. They're human. Do you already know that? Have they told you what they are, who they are? If they haven't, I'll tell you. Okay, so now I'm going to give you some insight about the people on that blue spaceship and on the ships that are coming over your house. They are actually star people. When I say star people, that terminology of a star person is they are men and women from some other planetary system beyond Earth. So have they communicated with you in terms of where they're from?
No.
Okay. All you need to do is ask because you're already in communication to them. You just need to say, I would love to ask you, where are you from? And ask them. Ask them their names. Ask them where they're from. Don't be afraid to ask them. They're waiting for you to really want to learn and understand who they are. You know, they want you to communicate with them. I'm getting really strong indications that the next step for you is, since 2022, it's time for you to make communications with them. If you are not afraid to do this, you can ask them, when can you physically make contact with me? I would love to communicate with you. Are you in an area, an open area in your state? Are you in an area where there's not a lot of homes and people?
I'm like in the suburbs, so there is a lot of homes, but
You can.
I'm on an acre.
You're on an acre.
Around me.
How far away from your suburban area is their country? Is there any? Are you far away from like open spaces?
Yeah, if you probably. Were to go, I could go somewhere close.
Yeah.
Somewhere, so but they go across state lines. They follow me everywhere. Yeah.
They follow you everywhere. So here's the thing. I'm getting information for you. This is really important. This is what I do, people, on my nighttime show. When people tell me stories, I can read information. So they want to communicate with you. They would like to meet with you. They are human. They are very beautiful, to tell you the truth. I don't know much about where they come from, though. I do know that they come from a place of pure love. And I'm seeing in my understandings that I'm getting for you now, I'm operating in a slightly different consciousness at the moment besides talk shows. When I get this information, I got to give it to you now. They want to communicate with you, not just telepathically. They would like you to meet them. So I'm getting information that it's supposed to be in an area that's outside of the suburban area. Since they follow you, you have to find an area where it's an open space, I'm told, and they would be able to actually land their ship in a field. So they're able to land their ship in a field. I'm seeing some sort of a field, like in my consciousness, there's this field, and the ship is, give me a second. It's very luminous. The ship is very luminous, and they want to communicate with you directly. You're part of, and you having the human experience. You're a very loving person. You have a very beautiful energy about you. You also, you come from a very loving place. You have come from that place most of your life. Even when you weren't open to this, you still had a very loving energy, correct? You love
Oh yeah.
people. You
Yeah.
do. I know you
Yeah.
do. And they are from that same place of love. So it is time for you to step forward into another part of your life with this. The next step is going to be you're going to find a place. It'll be a good energy area. You're going to find a place that's a field. It's going to be a big field. And it's going to be a place where they will be able to meet you one-on-one. They'll be able to, I'm not sure if they're going to use a smaller craft from a bigger craft, but they are going to want to make contact with you. And it's time for you to be part of that. You're going to meet people that you're connected with because you came from the stars before you came here. It's in your energy field. When you look at your face, I can see the star being within you. It's in the very essence of your being. And they are going to communicate with you. And you're going to learn many things from them. You're connected with them.
I would love
Did you know
that.
this?
No, I mean, I
You
knew
didn't?
that they came, I came from them, or they were watching over me.
Yes. And the reason
And
why they're watching over you is because you are from where they are. You're a star seed. You have biological Earth parents, just like I did. My parents are no longer here. But I have non-biological parents on the spaceship of the command. And you'll learn about that Friday night when we do our Astro Command Q&A, which is at 11 p.m. Friday. But yeah, you're connected with them. They come from a very distant planetary system beyond Earth. I have no idea what the name of it is. I just get the information that they are definitely just they always are here for you. They've been watching you all your life since you were a baby. And even though you weren't open to it, they helped you unlock that cover, what you call the blinds, so to speak. So
Oh.
you've been with them. They've been watching you all your life. And you'll find that not only have they been watching you, but your cosmic family is on that ship. That's why they're watching you. Your biological cosmic family is on that spaceship. You're going to have that. I think this is what we were talking about. We talked about this with certain people already. This is going to happen for everybody. This is what people have to know. You're a prime example of what's happening now around the planet. Since 2022, you're having these telepathic communications with them, and you're going to have an experience at some point soon, I think, where they're going to want to meet you. You're going to be probably having physical encounters. Were you aware of that at all? Did you have any
Not
inner
the physical,
understanding?
yeah, not the physical contact. I haven't been told that much. I just knew that. I mean, they knew me somehow because they allowed me to take
Yes.
photos of them.
Well, they knew you
And
because you're part of their family. That's why they know you. You see, when we get connected like that, that's because that's our cosmic family. And they know you.
see,
They
the weird
love you.
thing
They're
too,
connected
like
with you.
people
Morning,
say
Grace.
that, like that someone said, I feel she has Rh negative blood. See, that's the thing. I don't.
Yeah.
Unless,
I.
Unless there's like a false hidden thing about me. Because that's
Yeah.
what they told me at one time,
Yeah.
that I was hidden from some reason. I'm like, okay,
Right.
I don't know what that
Well, it's
means.
so the space people told you were hidden. Did they
Yeah.
explain what
I
that
was under
meant?
a fake, and I don't know, like a fake identity or something.
Huh. That's interesting. But
It
your
wasn't
true
me.
nature, yeah, your true nature that we see here, you're beaming with a lot of radiant energy of love, and you can see that in the very smile that you have. How can anyone not like you looking at your smile? Any person out there,
You'd be surprised. You'd be surprised. I am
But
so much of an outcast. I never get.
you know what? That's what happens when you're from another planet and you're in human form. You can be considered an outcast. Understand that to be an honor to be an outcast on this planet because you're not from here. If only everyone else who thinks you are an outcast was also an outcast, they would understand. But you have, when you found this show, you'll find that no one thinks you're an outcast. You are totally, totally beautiful. And you should
Thank
always
you.
be, always look at that and don't, whatever anyone says to you, whatever they think of you, don't even let that get to you. You are who you are. If they don't get it, that's their problem, you know?
Yeah.
You don't have to worry
Okay,
about
so I'm
anyone's
gonna try
thoughts.
to. So on Facebook, you are Commander Alien.
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna try to
Yep.
send you the videos if
Yeah.
I can.
Yep. And if you want to friend me there too, because I have two Ashtar groups on Facebook. I have an Ashtar CE5 group, and I have my Ashtar Command group. Those are my two main groups on the Facebook. So it's giving used car selling, I think, out of the box. It's giving, I don't understand the comment. It's used car salesman. What does that mean? It's giving you, can you explain yourself out of the box? Do I have to mute that person? Let's see here. Okay, let me just do this here. Let's see. Okay, I think we Dr. Greer says we make contact by mental telepathy. Yes, we do. Telepathy is the way we do it. Dr. Greer's right about that. Meditation. Yes, I agree. I actually interviewed Dr. Greer in 1993 up in New Hampshire at the New Hampshire MUFON conference. Yeah, she's going to send me, Ryan, some of the videos by Messenger, and I'm going to try to figure a way to put it on my tablet. Through my tablet, I'll try to show it on here one night when she's on. Yeah, I'm on Facebook under CmdrAleon, Commander Aleon. Yep. People are
That's
asking
what I'm
about
trying
Facebook.
to get. I'm trying to find you, and it's not bringing you up for some reason.
Try using let me actually see here. Message me after the show on here. I'll give you my
Okay.
account on Facebook. I'll do that. Okay, so it's
I don't.
yeah.
That's the thing is, though, in a way, it was like, so my friend and I found that I have positive blood. But then in my consciousness, I heard, no, you don't. And that's where they said I was hidden identity, whatever that
Right.
means.
Yeah, I'm not sure what that means. I'm sure they had a reason for saying that. Maybe the identity of your true nature of your star person being. Maybe that was the hit thing that was hidden. But
Incredible.
I'm not really sure
Don't
about
have
that. But
RH negative blood.
yeah. And you know what? It doesn't matter if the person have RH negative blood. I know some people have always, since I've been on TikTok, I always get that question. I think if you're from another planet, it really doesn't matter what your blood type is. You're from another world. You're from another world. I think that's really the essence of what's really important.
Yeah.
And there are many people that are starseed or finding out they're from other planets, and it makes no difference. That's the last thing I ask the person when I meet them in person. Oh, can you tell me? And that's it's a natural question to ask. What is your blood type? I want to know where they're from, how they got here. I want to know their story. The blood type could be interesting, but it's not essentially important when you're dealing with being from another world and you're coming here to Earth and you're now remembering, oh, well, let's take a look at that. Wait a minute. I'm going to put that on the big screen. Let's take a look at that. So, can you explain what that is?
It was very yellow in my sky, and I wondered what it was. And I zoomed in to get a good picture, and that's what I saw. And I think it was the bottom. I think it was the bottom of a ship.
Yeah, no, let's keep your head out of the picture. Let people look at this here. So look at this. What year was this taken?
It was around the same time.
Same time.
I honestly, I don't know the dates. I can probably go find out on my camera.
So when you say the same time, like in 2022, when you were waking up, was that all when it happened, all these things, or later than that?
Later too. Like they continuously happen. Mm-hmm. Like when I, like in the winter time, I sometimes don't go out as much, but in mm-hmm. the summertime, I basically hang out with them.
That's really cool that you say you hang out with them. That's like, I'm going to hang out with my friends from my star family.
Yeah,
I'm saying that's great that you're actually comfortable enough to say, I'm hanging out with my star family. No matter what you think, I'm hanging out with them. I like that. That's great. This picture is absolutely beautiful. You know, this is a beautiful photo. And I think that is the under part of the spaceship.
I have a lot of plasma ships come around.
Plasma ships are great. You have plasma ships. Do you have any pictures mm-hmm. of them?
Let's see.
I know what the plasma ships are, so I'd love to have our audience see plasma ships.
I don't know if I have. I remember I have one. We'll see.
Yeah. Lori 36, thank you for the heart. We appreciate it. And for people watching the show, please support what we do. I've got my TikTok gift thing up here. And I'm pinning it. We've gotten three hats with mustaches. I want to, people to support that. If you have TikTok coins, you can do that. Or do my Cash App on Venmo here on my profile page. So I just, put my thing up there for the TikTok. The hat, the brown hat with the mustache. And while we're doing this, Robinson is trying to find some more pictures. I want to see some plasma ships. I know you probably do too. And I love the plasma ships. They've been documented in Brazil a number of years ago. A person documented plasma ships like crazy. So plasma ships are a little bit different.
I had something like that come up on my screen one time.
And can you describe... can you describe that bluish object?
It was really, really blue in my sky.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I took a picture of it. See, what they do is they hang out around me. So,
yeah.
I mean, if you're not really looking at them, they'll look like stars. But then at 6:30 in the morning, they'll either cloak up or they'll leave. And I have videos of them leaving.
Wow, this is amazing. I can't wait to look at some of your videos and then try to see if I can show them to people on here. So the plasma ships, how big are those when you've seen the plasma ships?
I mean, sometimes they're not huge to me sometimes. Like,
okay.
Yeah. A lot of the times I have to zoom in on them to get them really good in my fit up photos, but I'm looking forward to meeting them because they follow me everywhere. Like I went to Kansas over the weekend and they were there over like the restaurant, so it's kind of like I'll get this like inkling to look up. It's like, look up. Look up, I'm here. I was like,
it's amazing.
Pretty much, and if you're around me, you're going to see me going like.
You know what it is? As I listen more and more, they're also there to protect you. They're your star family. They truly are. They're there to protect you. Wherever you go, they'll be with you. If they feel you're in arm's way, they will actually protect you. You're really connected now. You're so connected. It is the most beautiful thing I'm hearing here. I mean, you're just totally connected. You know, there's no way around it. No matter what, looking at this, if you're watching this show, and this show will be on my YouTube channel, AstroCommand Spaceship News, after we, get done broadcasting, you're just the essence of pure light. There's nothing other than pure light coming through you. You, it doesn't matter what anyone thinks, you are having your experience. And it is just beautiful. And your stories are just beautiful. And you're constantly having contact, which is amazing. It's like, wherever you go, it's constant, correct?
Oh yeah, yeah. I even tried it. Like, I even like put it to the test. Like, I went mm-hmm. to Kansas to a family member's house, and
yeah.
So it'll sit up there a lot of the times, and it'll like go red, green, blue, purple, red, right. green, blue, purple. Right. And so I'm like, oh yeah, well there you are. Like,
well, hey. What they're doing is those colors are vibrational patterns of their ship. So when people say, why do ships have vibrational patterns of color? Human beings don't understand. Yeah, you know, and some people say the craziest things, like, why do spaceships have lights? Why can't they have lights? The human mind says they're looking at the thing of lights like a car light or like a jet light on a commercial airline jet. Spaceships, mm-hmm. hey, James, good to see you. Spaceships have vibrational patterns of light. Some ships do have, and a lot of ships can radiate, the radiant light comes to the ship. It's the vibrational energy from the ship. You know, that's why they have the lights. And this is a teachable thing. I try to teach people, no, you know, just spaceships are not supposed to have any radiant light coming from them. It's like human beings have this perception of like, spaceships do not have any lights. Why do they need lights when they're traveling through the multiverse or the universe or the galaxy? Why not? Why can't they have lights of different colors? You know, it's amazing.
It's really beautiful. Some of the lights some of this, you know, colors that come off of them are just like so vibrant. It's just wow. And so in the videos, you guys will hear me probably going, wow, hello, how are you? Yeah, you'll hear me say that in the video.
Yeah. And Grace is asking, my friend Grace, is when did your contacts start happening in the year 2022, correct?
Yeah, that's around, I mean, I think I remember seeing a light above my house in Arkansas, but not thinking about it.
Okay.
And that was like in 2021. So around 2022, 2023, it really kicked off. And it's been constant.
Now you're in the state of, I want to make sure I'm right, you're in the state of Arkansas, correct?
No, you're Missouri. Missouri.
Okay.
I moved states and they're still here. Yeah.
So she actually, Grace, wherever she goes, these ships, the space people follow her. It's pretty amazing. It's an amazing story. You know, I mean, I've been through a lot of people you know, let's say they've had a sighting, you know, they've had contact or whatever, visitations. I'm absolutely certain that they're, you know, you are absolutely ready to make contact with them. They're absolutely ready to make contact with you. But I am getting that it has to be away from the suburbs. You have to be, there's going to be a field somewhere. You'll know where to go. Matter of fact, they might even communicate with you where to go when you're traveling in your car. They'll tell you where to go and just go wherever they're telling you to go. And when that field is there, that's where you're going to have contact with them.
So I have watermelon emojis in my name because I
see. Do you grow watermelons?
No. I'm an activist as well as, you know, I guess alien contactee. Basically, I stand up for what's right, and I'm standing up for Palestine people. They get on TikTok. They tell me about what they're going through.
Yeah,
well, and because I love people. Yeah.
And that's because you are from beyond Earth. You're a star person. You don't want to see anybody die in wars. We're here to transform the earth. We're here to say, why is everyone killing everybody? Why are people bombing everybody, right? So yeah, you're doing, that's your light work. That's part of who you are, you know? So that's an extension of your star beingness to do what you're doing, right? It's all connected. It really is, you know?
Yep.
So good for you to do what you're doing, you know? It's really a good thing. And you are gonna have contact. I can't say more than that I just know I keep reading your energy so strongly. They're saying, we're going to be in contact with her. We're going to meet her in the field in where she is. They're going to connect with her, you in the field. And I can't wait to hear that story. You know? That's going to be awesome.
Go ahead. Oh, my word. Where'd it go? Sorry, hold on. I'm getting a picture.
No problem.
That happened.
She's got a lot of photos, folks. This is really good.
I do. If I can find it.
Oh, and that's not I'm going picture. To.
Wait,
okay.
On. Let me get a better picture. Hold on. Let me get a better picture. For some reason, they got my mind caught on these clouds. If you see how they're just like.
Yeah.
They're just scrolling. So I saw them do that. I don't know. They just said take picture and just look at those clouds. Look at those clouds.
Hey, dibbles.
And then I got home is then when I saw them start coming over my house. I'm like,
oh the space boy. The spaceships came over your house or the clouds?
No, those are the clouds that when I was out, but they were really okay. Pulling my attention for some reason, but they just were.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But then when I got home is when I started seeing them a lot, and it was pretty cool.
You start seeing the ships.
Yeah, ships, yeah.
Okay, yeah. I just want to clarify.
That got my attention.
Right, yeah.
Like, that got my attention, and then I got home, mm-hmm. like, 15-minute drive, and all of a sudden, they just started coming over.
Wow.
Like, a lot. Like, over, I saw, mm-hmm. like, over 10 or 15 ships.
10 or 15 ships.
Yes.
I would love to stand there and watch that. That would be way cool.
Yeah, it's wow. pretty cool. I know, that's what I'm saying. I'm like, okay, wow. Like, and they knew it too, right? Because in the wintertime, I don't like to go outside that much.
Yeah, I don't think most people do.
It's funny you know? As they knew that I was like, wow. Like, they knew that I was going out there. Like, they knew I was going out there to hang out with them. And they're like, you know.
Yeah.
Coming over.
And Terry Nolan, she's not talking about cloud crafts. The clouds were there, but the ships, she actually wasn't the clouds. The ships, she was looking a certain direction.
I mean, it could be. It could be. I don't know. But I didn't think so. I don't know. It could be.
Yeah.
I'll get another picture. Hold on. Let me see. I take a lot of pictures.
Yeah. Oh, you got a lot of photos. Mm-hmm. If you're not watching this show, folks, and you're watching somebody bouncing balls on TikTok, you're missing a great program here today.
Let me see.
Please share and like. We're at 20,000. We want to get to 100,000 likes by 12 noon.
So you remember that blue one? My friend edited the photos when we got it the first time.
Mm-hmm.
And if you kind of see it, you can see like.
If you move yourself out of the picture, they can see
it. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, no, not a problem. And then just narrate. Tell us what we're looking at.
You're looking at that blue one with it brightened up and trying to see what it is. And you can mm-hmm. kind of see like. It's light flowing through it. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah. And what's the blue part? Is that radiating from the center?
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
Okay. Interesting.
Yeah, that's the blue one that we saw earlier.
Interesting. And that's a closer picture of the blue one, which is kind of good that your friend was able to do that.
Yeah, because I was wondering, like, what is that?
Yeah. No, it's very interesting. You know?
So this one was interesting.
Oh, let's take a look at that. Can you explain what that is and how close it was?
It was a light. It caught my eye. It was just up above me, like in my sky. Above me.
Above you. How far above you was it? Like 100 feet, 1,000 feet, 2,000 feet? Can you figure that out?
I mean,
I
don't know.
If you had a guess. Well, if you had to take a guess, like.
Not 100,000 feet. No.
No, like maybe like, 200 feet above you.
Sometimes they hang at the tree level. Sometimes they hang out the tree level.
The tree level,
sometimes
okay.
Sometimes they hang out a little bit above the tree level.
Interesting. That's pretty low, though. A tree level for an object, that's really low.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Sometimes.
That's amazing, folks. Everybody look at the picture. Focus on the photo she's showing you, and look at the picture.
To me, it looked like a wolf or a dog.
Mm-hmm.
Or some kind of being that's a wolf or a dog.
Huh, interesting.
Yeah.
Very interesting. Well, you've been a great guest. You've showed us so much. I can't wait to see the stuff you messaged me with on those videos. I'm going to try to transfer them over so people can, and I'll let you know when I'm doing that. So I'll have you on and we'll narrate the videos on the show because I want you to be part of that experience too, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Very much so. You are just a great guest. Everybody, let's give a round of applause for Robinson for coming on the show as our first guest this morning. And it's just, you've been phenomenal. You're just a phenomenal guest. You've just been sharing some great things. This is what this show's about. This is what I'm here to do. I'm here to bust the matrix, have people come out of the closet, show what they're going through. And you just did that. And so many people have before you done that who were never on the show before. And I'm here to let you know that this show is better than Good Morning America, BBC, whatever country you live in. If you watch this show, you're going to get real information. You want disclosure, it's going to be on this show. It's not going to be on YouTube. It's not going to be on people who have agendas. The only agenda I have here is to bust the matrix. And every one of you are doing it. Robinson, you're doing it. Everybody on here who's been on this show, interviewed, you're doing it. Sharing your stories, you're doing it. So thank you so much for being here. You are a blessing.
Thank you.
And keep in touch and message me. And I've already friended you. So we'll be friends here. I want to make sure I am following you. Yeah, I am. So you're good to go.
I can't find you on TikTok or I can't find you on Facebook. So I'll send you my Facebook profile link.
Okay, and I'll send you my link. We'll connect.
Yeah, that works. Okay.
All right. Peace. All right. There we go. Let me do this here. This is what we do, folks. You know, this is what we do on the show. Now you know what we do on the show. And so many good people out there all over the world having contact. I told you, wherever they are, in the United States, Europe, wherever, I know people are having contact. Her story is beautiful because she's having contact with beautiful space people that I know she's going to make physical contact with soon. I just know it. I just feel it in my essence, in my energy. What a great guest. You're watching Encounters, the morning edition. We're usually on late night, and we love interviewing people who are having these kinds of things, contacts. Directly with their space family, or you know, maybe it be ET orbs, or maybe it's sighting reports. It could be Bigfoot, Sasquatch. It could be bird people, all that stuff. Fairies. We want to hear your stories, definitely. Len, good to see you. Denise, good morning. Adam, three, welcome. So we're gonna soon knock out of here, so we can get on the road and do some things. Since I have a day to just relax. And we just are glad everybody's here. Wayne, good morning. Thank you for the likes. So does anybody else have a story as beautiful as that you like to share? You have to have over 200 followers on TikTok to go audio. If you have over 800 now, evidently lowered it to 800 followers. If you have over 800 people following you, Blazing Madame May, I'm following you. I'm bringing Blazing Madame May on the show right now. That's how the commander works.
Hello.
Hey, Blazing Madame. I can't speak English.
Over like, oh, I think 2,000 something followers on TikTok. I'm actually a medium. I quit doing it because I didn't really like... I just started having really bad vibes doing this on TikTok. But right. I go out and...
Well, can you bring your camera on? Can you bring the camera on so we can see you?
I don't want to bring my camera on right now because I haven't got my makeup on or anything. I just saw you.
Oh, okay.
I'll do it again. But I want to tell you what I do. And if you go to my TikTok page, you can see it. And I go out, I've been out a few times, and what I do is I just go walking and I leave my camera on and I just walk. And I know you're not gonna believe this, but I pick up on little tiny dots that just kind of appear, and they're moving so fast that I can catch them with my eye. But in order for my viewers to see them, I have to slow it down to almost, I have to go on to, cap cutters, and I slow it down, as much as I possibly can. as much as I possibly can. To and it comes up as just, I mean, as a wink, and like you could barely see it, but you can see it. And I get these things all the time, and every time I go out, I can capture something. But I know it's like, how do I make my viewers believe that I'm not, this is real. These are real. I don't know what they are.
Now, let me ask you a question. So these little dots, and what state are you located in? What part of the planet, by the way? I was always like to ask
I'm
that
in
question.
Maryland.
Maryland. Okay. So these little dots, are they really high up in the sky, just to give our audience some sort of an idea of what we're looking
they
at?
They're at any time of the day, and they're all over the places. They go over houses. I've got them. I got one captured going over the houses. I've got them at night in the sky. I've got them on the ground. I've got them. I mean, like every single time. Now, I don't know if I'm just in tune with this sort of energy. I do this, and I know that if you saw this, you'd be like, she's just making this up. But I'm honestly not, and I'm just like, it is just the weirdest thing, and I'm gonna keep on doing it and putting it out here on TikTok, because it's like every time I go out, I capture something.
What do you feel like beyond capturing it? Are you getting any indications of what it is?
I honestly think they're fairies.
Fairies, okay. We have a friend on something. Here in Vermont who sees fairies. If she was on here, she probably would tell you that.
Yeah. But you can go on my TikTok page. My name is Blazing Madam May.
Okay.
And you can see these things.
Yeah, I want to take a look at that for sure.
Yeah, you're gonna have to tell me what you think, and I swear to God, I will go out if you ask me. I can go out and to like tonight, any time of the day, and I can capture something out there, and it's moving so fast.
You're gonna have to be dressed and ready to come on camera and show us that one day.
Yeah, I will. It's just, and I started noticing it when I was like. Is this just, are these just dots appearing? Like I noticed like, okay, my dog was in a house. We were in an old house and my dog, and I kept on seeing these lights over my dog. Now that could, I do have that up there and you will see that. And they look like little orbs. And I honestly cannot tell you, you will see that big time. And my dog passed away, but I'm thinking now, Is that just the lighting? Because it could have been just the lighting. It could have been just the lighting. It could have been. Now, I'm not 100% sure. Okay, but it does look like an orb is following my dog.
Well, we'll have to look at it, I think, we'll have to look at it.
That was one thing. And then I went out, and then I just started photographing stuff like, you know, just walking around with the camera, see what my camera would pick up. And then I started noticing these, like, just these like little dots that would just kind of flash out. And you really gotta look at the, like, my last mate page. You gotta really look hard at it. But you can see it's coming up, and it will be there. And granted, I put it down on, I'm not a, you know, a professional photographer, or I don't have any kind of experience with this kind of stuff at all.
Right.
But so I did this as best as I could. I slowed it down as much as I could in CapCut and say, you really got to look at it and you will see it. But it's real. It's real. It's just something that is just appearing.
Blazing, I have my friend from Vermont on. She knows a lot about this. Would you like to have her come on? And she's, you know, you tell her what you're seeing. I think you are seeing fairies. And hey, April, and she sees the fairies all the time in Vermont, which she's in the mountains up in near the Canadian border.
Okay.
So let me bring her up because she does know about that.
Okay.
That's one of her backgrounds.
I would love to have her take a look at some of this stuff and tell
you let her
what
know
she
if she
thinks.
Can take a look at your footage. I'm going to bring on here now.
Okay.
And see if she can come on here, and then because it sounds to me these things could be, my understanding of fairies is relatively, I mean, I've known about the word fairies.
And the thing is, I am a medium. I have had experiences with the dead since I was a little girl.
Well, we want to stay away from the paranormal. We want to stay away from the paranormal.
I have gotten on TikTok and actually proved that to people. You know, that's why I got a following so fast. But I don't know what it is. I just got really discouraged by doing that on TikTok. I started tuning more into this fairy stuff, but I don't work with fairies. I've never tried to contact a fairy, but that's the only thing I can think these things are.
Right. So I'm going to give you over to April. She's in near the Canadian border. She has constant contact with the fairies. She knows everything about them. So say hello, Blazing, to April, Friends with Fairies.
Hi. So, what are you seeing now?
Okay. I do have it on my page. I am under Blazing Adam May. I go out. Okay. What I started noticing is one day I was just messing around and I was photographing my dog and I started noticed like an orb over my, like the, I was looking at the video and I was like, is that an orb over my dog? Like it looked like a dot of light was following my dog around and you can see it really good. If you go to Blazing Madam May and you can see it really good.
Okay.
But I don't know. I'm not 100% sure if that wasn't lighting because I don't know, you know, but then I started going outside and I started just taking walks and I would capture this stuff and they're like little dots, right? But they're moving so fast that I would see it. But I was like, what the hell is that? You know, I would see it and it was like, it would be going so fast. So I had to put it into CapCut and I had to slow it down as much as I possibly could to get the viewer to see it. But it looks like, it looks like a just like dots coming and they're just like little white dots and then they're like over houses. I've got one up in the sky at night that comes out at night. It's like a little shining light. It just appears, but granted, it's going very, very fast.
Yeah,
that's
because fairies are dimensional beings and they don't see time and space the same way we do. So they move very quickly through our time. Their speed is like, it's crazy. It's like they're there 1 second and then they're gone. You know, you can just see them moving super quick. But the fairy that was following your dog around, that is a fairy, by the way, they love and are connected with animals. And that must be one that really, really likes your dog a lot. And that was actually a male fairy because, most male fairies do not have wings. They have to be gifted wings or higher up. In the fairy ranks to have wings. So what they do to travel is they create these orbs around them, these little orb lights. And so what you had following your dog around was a male fairy that must have really liked your dog a lot because they love animals.
Yeah. Well, it was, it's incredible. It's really outstanding. And I haven't done, but it seems like every time I go out now, and I decide to do this, and all I have to do is turn my camera on and walk. But then I have to go through the whole footage. And maybe I'll walk for like 40 minutes with my camera on, whatever time of the day. But then I have to go through the whole footage and then I have to find it. And it's always just kind of hard to see it, but I find it usually.
Yeah.
And then I have to take a good shot. And I have to slow it down, and then I can post it on TikTok.
Right.
But so if you could take a look at my footage sometime and see.
Absolutely.
It's great that and your name is?
My name is April.
Okay. And then you're on TikTok too?
Yeah. I'm Friends with Fairies 1111. And go ahead and follow me. I'm already following you. And then I'll take a look at your footage and I'll tell you what I think.
Yeah, she knows all about, April knows all about the fairies. She's in constant communications with them. She's probably the sole person, if you want to learn about the fairies, that's why I wanted you to connect with her, because she'll look at it and she'll know right away.
Okay, great. That would be great. And if you could just message me or contact me somehow and just tell me what you think about this stuff.
Absolutely. But the fact that they're showing themselves to you like that must mean you're a very high vibrational person, and they must trust you an awful lot, because they don't just show themselves to everybody, especially right now, because they're starting to come around with they want to work with humans more. And when the big contact does happen with our UFO families, when they do finally reveal themselves, the fairies are going to start coming out of the woodwork, because they're going to, the newer generation of fairies wants to start working with humans to start getting our earth back on track and getting it healthy again.
Yeah. And So you can contact me. I'm still getting familiar with, TikTok. So if you wanted to
you'll get there.
Email me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That would be great.
Yeah, I can message you right on TikTok, and it'll show that you have a message from me. So I'll take a look at your stuff, and I'll message you, and I'll tell you what I think.
Okay. I'll definitely befriend you. So.
Okay.
There you go.
Do you ever get on live?
Yes.
Oh, you kidding me? Yeah, she does. She goes live.
Yeah. Okay. All right. I do it occasionally. I was doing it for medium purposes only, but I don't know if I'm getting some kind of message, but I just feel like I've been actually told to stop doing that on TikTok.
Yeah.
For whatever reason.
I can't read it. I'm not really sure. Like, this is Commander Allen, the host of the show.
I am a medium. I read it. So emotional about what was going on, though, because of all these deaths going on with fentanyl and all the street deaths. A lot of people were contacting me about that. People that were getting shot and stuff like that. It really started depressing me.
Yeah, we stay away from all that stuff. And thank God you're getting out of it. You don't want to go there.
It was just like it was really starting to affect me. I'm an empathetic medium, in which when I do tune into somebody that has passed on, I actually I can feel what they felt. So if they got shot in the head, I can tell where they got shot at.
So we want to stay away from the paranormal just because
I did it just to kind of get some attention, but I just really started getting depressed. And I'm too empathetic to be a medium, to tell you the truth.
Yeah. Well, now you can let me tell you something. You can redirect that energy into the cosmic realm. You have the energy to do that. Do you realize that you were doing that, but you also can switch the switch and say, okay, I'm throwing that switch out. I'm going to go into the cosmic galactic switch. Focus on the cosmic galactic part of you constantly, and tell yourself, I'm now going to work in the Christ consciousness. I do not wish to, even though I have the ability, I'm going to switch that switch off and elevate to the galactic cosmic air. If you do that and you're just focused on the cosmic levels of your consciousness, that's all you need to do. That's the most direct consciousness you have.
And he's speaking the truth. He really is, because I dove into all that stuff with my abilities, and I'll tell you that it wasn't where I needed to be. And where I need to be is where, like, working alongside of my brother that's the host of this show. And you know, I found that all that sadness and depression and all that stuff that I was taking upon myself, I stopped doing it, and I find a lot more joy and love in my life, because now I know that I have a bigger purpose versus just reaching past things that I can't do anything about, you know?
Yeah. And that's how I feel. I feel like I was not even by a human being. I feel like I was just directly told to quit doing this.
And that's awesome. That's awesome.
And that it was not more. It was not the way to go. Right. And maybe I was being even told by the fairies, because it's just amazing how many of these I had captured. So I just stopped altogether. And I think
if you start diving into the world of the fairies and all that you're going to find a lot of joy and love, because these beings bring a lot of joy into your life. So, and that's where you really want to be, is start heightening your vibrations with joy and love, and not things that you can't change.
And that's what I was finding. People were contacting me wanting to know, who killed this? It was depressing me. It was like, I can't tell you.
You're away from all that.
I can't point at murderers and I can't do that.
That's all negative stuff, and you want to steer clear of that. You want to start bringing joy and love into your life. You know, start reaching out to your fairies. They'll start guiding you in the right direction.
Yeah. Well, this is amazing. I'm really glad that I got on. I'm sorry, I have not. Actually, this, you know who this is a picture of is the this woman's with a picture of, but I can't, I mean, I can't call myself. It's Mad Madam Mims, my favorite character in the Disney movies. She plays the one that, you know, she's always the one going around arguing with Merlin in the Disney character. So, you know, I can see myself in her. So that's how I picked her, but I couldn't call myself Mad Madam Mims. I called myself Blazing Madam May. And also, you know, I got that name too because I like that name because it reminds me of her.
That's awesome. Well, I hope that that helps you, and I will look at your videos and I will tell you what I think and I will send you a message.
And I would appreciate that.
Absolutely.
Okay. All right.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, and I'm going to be getting ready to sign out of here because I have things I want to do outside of this realm here. I want to thank
you guys. I'm going to go now because I got to get ready and go to work and all that stuff.
There you go. See, all the timing's right. Thank you, Blazing. Okay. Oh, thank you very much. Right, I'm going to go to the market and do a few earth-based things here. I enjoyed it. This show will be on my YouTube channel. I'm going to be also making a video when I get back for Friday night. So tomorrow night is Ashtar Command Q&A. We will be communicating and have, well, our space brothers on the ship are always watching the show, even if they're not here right now, but they are watching. But the actual show for the Ashtar Command thing, you're going to love it. Tomorrow night at 11 o'clock, we will take Q&A questions regarding Ashtar Command, who they are, who we are, what they are, all that stuff. So feel free to ask questions. I think it's Grammar Me. Thank you for the heart me. We appreciate all the gifting. You guys are awesome. I want to thank all my moderators, Johnny, Grace, everybody out there. We love you all the people out there. Thank you for being here. But join us tomorrow night. I'll be on tonight, of course. Don't forget tonight. It is Thursday. I can't, you know, the days are getting kind of, who cares what the days are. But it's Thursday. And Thursday night, tonight, we'll be on live. And also Friday night, tomorrow night, we'll be doing our Ashtar Q&A. If you've never experienced it, this is a great way to ask questions about your star family. And we know definitely you're going to have a great time. Our space family tends to, with April, she has two phones. They have one phone specifically for intergalactic communications. They use one of her other phones, and you're going to experience this for the first time. They will usually communicate with words when they wish to. They'll use music. They know our music on Earth. They will use music to message a message to us. So it's a really beautiful thing to realize. April, thanks for answering her questions regarding the fairies. So we appreciate it. And if you're hearing some static, it's just that I got my ear pods on. I can hear everything here. So, and my phone is weird that way with my own experiences when I do lives. Things happen with my phone a little bit, not to the extent that it happens with her phones, but I'm very aware of everything around me. Again, thank you, everybody, for being here. This show will be recorded, so you can watch the show when I download it on my YouTube channel. Is Ashtar Command Spaceship News. You'll see I drain batteries. Interesting. We're going to have to – that is one of the things that does happen once in a while. You drain your own batteries when you're having real high energy. Had my extracto and still under sedation. Real news in the UK. Everybody, take care. I got to go. I got to sow some seeds today. I'm taking time to get my seeds going in the house. I got a greenhouse inside the house, and I'm sowing my watermelon seeds today as well. So lots of things to do. Everybody, take care. April, have a good afternoon up there in the Green State, and we'll catch you all later.
Bye, guys.